Hey guys, SuperHorrorBro Mike here, and in today's video, we're going to be looking at an update for the Five Nights at Freddy's movie from Scott Cawthon himself. Scott, of course, the series creator, and the person who pitched this movie, I believe, to Blumhouse Productions in 2015. Now, since then, it's had a number of directors attached to it and a number of different sort of scripts floating around, and Scott has basically come out and said, here are all the script ideas that I've had over the years, as well as ones posed to me by studios, which some of which are really bad, and we'll get to those. And he posted on Reddit and basically just said, I want to show you guys and share with you today all of these different script ideas that aren't going to be appearing in the Five Nights at Freddy's movie. But with this update, he also provided us with some details for what will be included with the Five Nights at Freddy's movie when it launches, hopefully in the next year or so. So this is an interesting video, guys. If you are interested in the Five Nights at Freddy's movie, the way we're going to do this video, I'm going to read you Scott's post. We're going to have a look at each of these scrapped ideas for the movie, but I'm also going to give you my takes on each of these scripts. So once I've read Scott's statement per script, I'll sort of break it down and say what I think of that idea and if I would have liked it or not. So kind of a fun video today, guys. We're just going to chat about the FNAF movie, look at Scott's update, and basically go through all of these different script ideas. So let's begin by reading his statement. The statement is titled Bad News About the FNAF Movie. Hi everyone, before we get to the bad news concerning the state of the Five Nights at Freddy's movie, I wanted to share a brief history of the FNAF screenplay. It's been a long road, so let's take a look at some of the screenplays that have come and gone over the years. Some of these came from big studios, some from big directors, some from me, and some other from hired writers. I gave the screenplays a name, and I'll include a brief synopsis as well as what ultimately led to each script being rejected. So let's get started. The F screenplay. The basic setup: a group of teenage troublemakers break into Freddy's and chaos ensues. Problems: although a basic setup, there were a lot of odd choices here, which only got weirder as the stories continued. The story ended with our protagonist in a secret underground animatronic factory that was designing robots for the government. Verdict: what the hell, strayed way too far from the source material. Tossed. So this was the first screenplay, guys, the F screenplay. Sounds like a simple, you know, what a movie studio would generally do with an IP like this. Group of teenagers break into Freddy Fazbear's pizzeria, everything goes wrong, and then they eventually get down to the basement, and of course, this is where the government sort of ties into it. They're designing these killer animatronics, and it kind of jumps the shark a bit, as the term goes. It does sound like most of this story would have been okay, but as Scott says, you know, there were some odd choices, and definitely the ending, where they just sort of discover the government's behind everything, seems a little bit sort of, I don't know, just terrible really, doesn't it? So it kind of seems like this kind of worked in part, but just didn't stick the landing at the end. And this would have been an okay one if they had probably tweaked it a little bit, but yeah, you can see why it's scrapped. The next one is called Plushies Take Manhattan. Basic setup: Plushies Take Manhattan. Problems: Plushies Took Manhattan. Verdict: Burned with Fire. So yeah, Scott doesn't really go into any detail on this one, and it's pretty obvious to see why. This would have been kind of like, I guess, a Gremlins type thing or a Puppet Master type script. Again, it's typically what a studio hired writer would probably do when they have no idea what Five Nights at Freddy's is all about. And it seems to be about a haunted animatronic plushies, you know, like Plush Trap and sort of Plush Baby taking over Manhattan and just wreaking havoc there. Doesn't sound good, does it? I mean, there's nothing really to say about this. It would have been a terrible, terrible take on Five Nights at Freddy's. It would have probably done some serious damage to the brand, and I'm really glad Scott didn't even consider this one. The Random Charlie screenplay. Basic setup: Charlie and friends sneak into Freddy's after hours to retrieve a lost toy. Problems: now, although sharing some names of familiar characters from the series, these characters had nothing to do with their game and book counterparts. So, while featuring fairly familiar elements of the games, it seemed too loosely based on the game and lost a lot of its impact because of it. So the verdict is that it felt like a random bag of FNAF elements with no real stakes. Meh. This one to me, you know, it doesn't sound particularly exciting. It sounds kind of like it would have worked okay, because generally, you know, they're sneaking into Freddy Fazbear's pizzeria, you're going to run into animatronics there. The pitch for them having to go there was because one of the kids lost his toy, probably left it there during the day when they went for pizza, and of course at night is when all the problems arise at Freddy's, so they run into all these problems and the animatronics chase them down. But he says it just kind of felt too loosely based on the game. It didn't feel like it was really going to be something that the fans would enjoy, which meant that if the audience coming in that didn't know the games also didn't enjoy enjoy it, they would just have a movie for no one, so there's no real point sort of placing any bets on a screenplay like that. It sounded like it would have been okay, but just nothing special, and I think with Scott, he really wants to make sure that everything he puts out for Five Nights at Freddy's, where possible, is of a higher standard, especially when it's made by other people and companies and not directly by him. So I think looking at this, he just thought it's not worth, you know, going ahead with this, because a lot of money is obviously being spent when you greenlight a movie. The next one is the Silver Eyes screenplay. This is one I actually really like. I'm going to read this to you guys. Basic setup. Kira and I both worked on three versions of the Silver Eyes screenplay over the course of about a year, trying to find the right approach to the story from the first book. Problems. These were the first attempts I made myself to write a screenplay after realizing it was going to be difficult to find someone else who understood the lore well enough to do it. Unfortunately, it also meant these screenplays suffered greatly from my inexperience at writing. Even Kira with her writing expertise couldn't save them. Verdict, although these had some good elements, I ultimately decided to focus on making a screenplay from the games and not from the books. As Scott says here, guys, this was going to be based on the Silver Eyes book. And this, of course, was one of the Five Nights at Freddy's books that has come out over the years. I forget exactly what happens in it because there are so many, and it all kind of blurs into one at this point. But yeah, it would have had a slightly different story that deviates from the games and embraces that of the Silver Eyes book instead. It sounded like the book's writer Kira was going to be involved, and this could have been a good one. It just probably would have divided fans of the games and books into separate camps. And again, it means if people who didn't know Five Nights at Freddy's came into this movie and didn't enjoy it, you'd only have a small portion of a fan base that this movie was made for. That's always risky. That's always a risky proposition. So they scrapped it. Probably wasn't a bad script, this one. Just didn't quite work for what they wanted. The Pawn Shop screenplay. This is my personal favourite, guys, so let me just read what Scott said about this. A kid watching over a pawn shop finds trouble when an animatronic is brought in. It turns out Freddy's has been robbed, and the animatronics were taken to different locations for sale. The other animatronics come to retrieve the one at the pawn shop, and the kid and his friends get roped into the adventure. Problems. A creative approach, but felt a little too much like a boy and his animatronic. Too much after-school adventure, not enough horror. Verdict, seemed like a good idea at the time. Now this is actually one of my favourite screenplays, guys, on this list. The Pawn Shop screenplay, to me, I know Scott says there wasn't enough horror in it and it felt a little bit sort of, he says like after-school adventure, I'm guessing he's talking about a bit like Stranger Things, something like that, like those kind of 80s movies. I actually really like stuff like that, so for me, this screenplay idea of a kid, you know, looking over a shop and Freddy being taken there as sort of like, you know, an antique almost at the pawn shop, and then his sort of other animatronics being drawn there and everyone having to battle out of this shop, that sounded really cool to me. I really liked his screenplay, and I would have definitely seen a Five Nights at Freddy's movie with this approach. I would have been very interested in this film. Scott's obviously saying it seemed like a good idea at the time, but he didn't think once they fleshed the script out that it was coming together properly. I trust what Scott says because he's directly involved with it, but all I'm saying is, for me, this is a clever idea. It deviates enough from the game that, you know, people coming into the film who didn't play Five Nights at Freddy's would have not got lost by it all. They would have also kind of found a movie for themselves there, and fans, I think, would have also enjoyed it because it would have retained the core elements of the series there as well. So for me, this is a good take, but it didn't go through, so there's no point dwelling on it. We're going to move through to the next one, which is called the Cassidy screenplay. The basic setup, deep dive. This screenplay packed in a lot of lore, following the story of Cassidy, spanning multiple time periods, following multiple characters, and featuring lore from multiple games. This was pretty saturated to a fault. It may have been satisfying to most hardcore fans, but it would have left the majority of people confused and lost. Hey wait, maybe this was the most accurate screenplay. Verdict? Ultimately, more of a visual encyclopedia than a movie, this just wasn't satisfying even to me. Out. Cassidy, guys, as you know, is probably the most mysterious character from any of the Five Nights at Freddy's media. She is said to be the girl haunting the Golden Freddy suit. Sort of Cassidy is meant to be this girl that was killed and then went on to possess Golden Freddy, but we don't really know for sure anything about her. All this sort of states is that she was canon to the story if they were going to make a movie all around her, and it would have fleshed out her story, but because she is such a marginalized character in, you know, know, even the mainline games, I think people would have probably either been super interested or not, depending on how much they care about Cassidy as part of the games. And also, Scott just says this was really kind of focused on being so true to the games that it almost felt like an encyclopedia of, you know, references to the games, which meant fans would like it, but anyone else watching would just have no idea what was going on and probably wouldn't care for the film. It didn't flow like a movie needs to, it just more felt like a sort of fact sheet. I'm not so bothered about this one. I mean, it would be cool to find out a bit more about the Cassidy character, but it just sounds like it was being way, way too detailed. Probably not something that would work well in the format of a movie, perhaps a TV show or something instead. The Misfit screenplay is next. The basic setup: single mom brings her kid to a new town, kid finds Freddy's, hilarity ensues. Problems. One of the problems in creating a modern day story with an old Freddy setting is finding a way to connect the protagonists to the restaurant, finding a reason for them to be there, and finding a reason for them to stay. The problem here was that the reason for a kid to go to Freddy's and have the misadventures was too contrived and too forced. So the verdict is not a bad setup, but it just didn't work. If I didn't care about the characters, then there's a good chance no one else will either, so pass. This was going to be the screenplay for a while because it didn't have any serious flaws. I just ultimately decided it wasn't good enough though. So the Misfit Kids screenplay was basically what Scott was going to go for a long period of time. We've obviously heard that the Five Nights at Freddy's movie has been in and out of development limbo for a number of years now, and this was one of the screenplays it seems they were going to shoot with at some point. But as you can see from reading it, it just looks a bit standard. It didn't look like it jumped out for any particular reason, you know, there was nothing exceptional about it. And Scott kind of thought, well, we want to do right by this franchise when we do our first movie, so unless it's really sitting well with me, which this wasn't, it's not going to be made. And, you know, my personal thoughts on this one, I think he probably went with the right choice there because it seems a little generic, this one, a little basic. The Ghost Trackers screenplay. Basic setup: a group of amateur ghost trackers sneak into the abandoned Freddy's. Problems. Although a very common sense setup for this sort of movie, the problem again arose about how to give these characters a connection to Freddy itself. What ended up happening was too much of the story went to their own backstories and their own hardships, and it took spotlight away from the story of Freddy's. Verdict: a stronger connection between protagonist and Freddy's was needed. Lesson learned. So this one was a ghost hunting one. I think this would have been fun, but it seems like it was more of like a drama about the lives of the characters in the screenplay rather than the animatronics attacking them and having fun at Freddy Fazbear's Pizzeria. So this was kind of more of a humanized tale, I guess, looking into the lives of the people in the story rather than what everybody really wants, which is, you know, action alongside animatronics and scares and all that. So it seems like it was okay, but, you know, nothing special, and quite rightly they put this one in the no pile. The Insane screenplay. Basic setup: another ghost tracking variation. This one involved the Funtime animatronics, underground ball pit tunnels, and a marionette out for revenge. Problems. As some other screenplays ventured too far into adventure, this one went too far into action. Verdict: too all over the place, with too many characters doing too many things. I really like the idea of the Funtime animatronics getting their own movie and, you know, having like ball pit tunnels and a marionette out for revenge. It all sounds like really claustrophobic, almost like a Saw movie, you know, with like lots of trap rooms and scares. And this one actually sounds like kind of like a fun house almost of terrors, which I like the idea of. But Scott said it was too actiony, it was too all over the place, and there was too many characters in there. It sounds like it would have just been a bit of a mess of a movie despite having some good elements, so it didn't get put through. I would have liked to see this film, I'm not gonna lie, but obviously we don't have too much detail on it, so it obviously just wasn't working. And then finally we have the Mike screenplay. Basic setup: this makes sense. Why didn't I think of this before? Problems: actually, this is a good mix. It has the best pieces from all previous screenplays. Not really any problems here. All the right characters, all the right motivations, all the right stakes. Verdict: yeah, we're going with this one. It's fun, it's scary, and it has a great central story. So this screenplay, guys, is the one they're actually going for, and of course Scott having a bit of fun there, leaving it till the end. The Mike screenplay, I'm guessing Mike Schmidt, you know, or Michael Afton as we know him, you know, William Afton's son, and probably telling an origin story as to William Afton, his son Michael, and all the misadventures he has over the years. I don't know if they'll cram it all into one movie, but if they are loosely using the game storyline, perhaps we'll finally get some concrete answers without sort of just going to our theories about the story of the original Five Nights Nights at Freddy's games and the story of Michael Afton, if this is Michael Afton it's talking about. But this is very exciting news because it seems Scott is just going to take the story of the games, give us some real answers on stuff, so he's going to please the fans and also explain things nice and easily for people coming into Five Nights at Freddy's who have no idea what it is and just want a fun horror movie on a Friday night. So this one seems really exciting, and this is the screenplay they are going with. Then he finally finishes by saying, "Oh right, so onto the bad news. Well, the bad news is, there won't be any more screenplays to add to this list since we're officially making the Mike screenplay. Filming starts in spring." So finally guys, we've got a date. Filming is going to begin in spring. Hopefully the pandemic does not halt filming or cause any problems. Hopefully we, you know, start to recover from this now and all the movies and TV shows and games being made can resume their old schedules and get made. And if filming begins in spring, depending on how quickly they finish that up in post-production, we could be seeing a Halloween release for the Five Nights at Freddy's movie. It's probably more likely this is now 2022 because movies take time to make, but there is a chance we could get a Five Nights at Freddy's movie next Halloween, and how great would that be? Or maybe next December or something in time for Christmas, but it would certainly be cool. I'm really excited for this film because it seems like, you know, the years have gone by. Scott's taken like, what, 5 or 6 years to get to write screenplay here. He obviously is going to make sure that what we get at the end of the day is a really, really great movie for the fans and newcomers alike. And because he's taken that time and worked with Blumhouse, who have made some really incredible films. They've done like Insidious, I think they did the Conjuring films. So Blumhouse have obviously made these really great horror movies. They're a fantastic, fantastic horror studio, and I really think that with Scott's sort of script that he's writing by the sound of it, and Blumhouse, who are known for great horror movies, we're actually going to get, at the very least, a competent Five Nights at Freddy's film, and hopefully a really, really great one. So let's look forward to this, guys. Another nice thing for 2021, alongside, of course, Security Breach, which is now confirmed for next year too. It looks like we're going to get Security Breach in the spring, then FNAF movie news over the summer, and then it releases perhaps in the winter. And of course, we've got all the fan games, the fanverse games that will be coming out. So much Five Nights at Freddy's stuff next year. We'll be covering all of it right here. So if you did enjoy this video and you want to see more Five Nights at Freddy's here on the channel, hit that like button, leave me a comment below, let me know what you think of the movie, if you're looking forward to it or not, and of course subscribe for more horror related content, and I will see you all on the next video.